Locker? Where would I find a locker nearby? That's the locker room. I hope it's not you, Peter. Poor Aaron. Oh.
Thank you.
This is it.
I know it looks tempting, but please do not destroy that plasma container. It powers this whole laboratory. Sorry for making you run around like that. But because of the recent increase in Terminator patrols, I couldn't get to that spider scout myself. Can I see it? Thank you. I have a gift. As a token of my appreciation. While you were out looking for my spider scout, I used some leftover parts to make a new radio for you. I've been picking up your signal for a while now, and I imagine that Skynet has as well. So, I've made it harder to decipher. You won't have to worry about them eavesdropping.
You've been listening, so you know why I'm here.
Yes. Now, let me see that gun. What a beauty. I've got to tell you, if Skynet wasn't so gung-ho about killing everything... What's interesting about it is that the matter inside is far more condensed. That way, it releases more energy on discharge, dealing much more damage. And also, its plasma blast is violet, so that's different.
Can you bypass the encryption lockout so we can use it? Alvin couldn't.
Alvin couldn't bypass an egg timer if his life depended on it. I'll do it, but it's not that simple. First, you'll have to bring me Skynet's latest security codes.
Security codes?
They will allow us to access Skynet's mainframe. But they change them regularly, so I need you to connect to any HK unit and download the newest security codes. To do that, you'll need my code reader. When I was... excused from the shelter, they made me leave all my equipment behind. Alvin should have my code reader.
Okay, is that everything?
As far as the security codes go, yes.
Then I'm moving out.
Actually, I've got a question about that infiltrator that you have there. Is it intact? Or more specifically, its neural net CPU? I've been hacking Skynet's units, and I'm noticing similarities in their patterns. I think I'm ready to reprogram the CPU from that infiltrator. It's more powerful than any other.
Should I ask Baron about that, too?
No, she can't know about it. She would not approve. I know how this sounds, but you need to steal it for me.
What?
I'm the only one that can reprogram that chip. For some reason, Skynet has started to learn at a geometric rate. We need to prepare ourselves for whatever's coming, and I believe that having an infiltrator on our side will give us the advantage. Just think about it.
Commander.
Rivers, what's the status?
Max alive. He will help us, but he needs a device he left at the shelter.
All right, we can do that. Report to me when you get back.
Over and out. I have to say, you're doing quite well without my help. What are you doing here? You have to get the ones you care about to leave the shelter. They'll be in great danger if you don't do what I say. But remember, Jacob, that has to stay between us. Why? Because things need to play out the way they're supposed to, that's why. I have been here from the beginning. Each of your friends already knows the reason they need to leave. You just have to remind them. Can I tell Commander Baron? No, she won't allow it. Then she will start to question you and keep you away from your missions. That cannot happen. Who the hell are you? That I can't tell you. It could change the choices that you make in the future, and we can't have that. So whatever happens, you can't know my identity. Not yet, at least. Do you know anything about a CPU that Mac wants me to steal? I do. If hacked, we could take over an infiltrator. Dr. Mac is capable of doing that. I'm not so sure if Alvin can. I think you should steal it. I think I'm more confused than I was before. Just stay focused. We'll see each other soon.
It's quiet. You know, quiet's good. Quiet means we're not getting shot at.
Rivers, DN 46890.
Welcome back, Sergeant.
Hey, Jacob, did you see Jennifer on your way here?
Isn't she here?
She hasn't come back yet, but I'm sure she's fine. About Hollywood Hills, how did it go?
I've been to Hollywood Hills and found your old house.
Did you?
Found Peter's body there. They got him, but he left you a letter. I'm sorry.
I have to get back to work. God knows there's plenty to do.
Aaron.
What, Jacob?
Do you understand what I'm saying?
And what do you want me to do about it? Weep for him in front of you? Believe me, I have plenty of sleepless nights in my future. But excuse me if I'm not going to make a spectacle of myself in front of everyone. I want to be left alone now.
That Dr. Mac's still alive.
Yeah, if I ever get my hands on him, I swear to God.
Huh, you're back. How was Hollywood Hills?
Crawling with Terminators.
And what about Mac? How's he? Is he compliant?
Fine, but he needs Skynet security codes if we want him to reprogram that plasma rifle.
Fair enough. Talk to Alvin about that.
Okay. I will.
Did Mac say anything else?
No, that's all he said.
Okay. Talk to Alvin about those security codes and then come back to my quarters. I'll tell them to let you in. And one more thing, talk to Ryan. That buggy's been sitting there broken for too long. See if something's going on. I've got a suspicion that he's hiding something from me.
Alvin!
You know what? I'm actually jealous of Mac. He's out there alone. No one's bothering him. If I had those working conditions, I would be just as successful as him.
He told me that I'll need some sort of a device to download Skynet security codes from an HK. Do you have it?
Yes. About that. Do you remember that day in downtown? I do. It was very traumatic. And because of that, I may have forgotten to bring back some things.
Including that device.
And the quantum battery which powers it. You won't be able to use it without it.
So, I guess I'm off downtown.
Yes, you do that. Don't touch that! That's how things get lost! Don't touch that! That's how things get lost!
Hey, Jacob, what's happening?
Baron wanted me to ask about that buggy. Is there a problem?
Yes, he's been nagging me to fix the electronics in his piece of shit for a while now. Do you think he can help me with it?
Why are you asking me? You're the mechanic.
Listen, I'm good with tools. You give me a car with a gasoline engine, I'll make it run. But this electronic shit? I don't know anything about that. Hell, most of my life, I live without electricity.
Why not tell her?
She won't let me cherry-pick my own responsibilities, you know that. She'll throw me right out of here if she finds out. That's why I need your help. Quartermaster will give you all the parts, tell you what to do. Just think about it. What's going on?
How did you deal with stuff like this before?
Oh, I usually ask Jennifer, one of the scavengers, to find a replacement for whatever it was I was supposed to fix. Yeah, I know. You don't have to say anything.
Who did you say had those parts?
The quartermaster.
I'll talk to him.
Sure. Take your time.
I'll get right to it. I'm here to pick up parts for that buggy.
Wasn't Ryan supposed to take care of that? Baron specifically asked me to keep an eye on it. Can he really fix it himself?
Sure he can. I'm just the delivery guy. That's it.
Yeah. All right. Here are the parts.
Thank you.
What's going on?
Oh, I've got those parts.
Great. Let's get to work.
And it's done.
All right, that didn't seem that hard after all. Thanks for the help.
Don't touch that. That's how things get lost.
I forgot.
What was I supposed to bring?
You know what? You're lucky. No one will ever mistake you for a machine.
What do you mean?
Those look like fives to you.
Commander's waiting for you.
Well, there goes nothing.
Commander.
Welcome to the luxury part of the shelter. But hopefully, we won't have to much longer. Thanks to people like us, this war will end soon. You proved that you'll do whatever it takes, no matter the cost. And so will I. Don't think your efforts go unnoticed. You know, I killed a man long before I killed my first machine. And was hurt by a man long before a machine's hurt me. Apart from plasma burns, I've got man-made scars underneath these tattoos that I'll never forget. On the good days, they don't hurt. And I feel like this world is worth fighting for. On the bad days, they make me want to quit. Give up and run like everyone else. But we're so close. Skynet's almost finished. So you can understand I can't run. I need your help, Jacob. I need you to get rid of Mac. He's unpredictable. He sabotaged our mission and killed our men before. I cannot let it happen again. I need you to kill him as soon as he reprograms that rifle. You look shocked. But I think I can find a way to persuade you. If you're into it, that is.
I am.
That's what I thought.
Commander.
Close the door behind you.
I really appreciate what you did for me. I won't bother you no more.
Don't touch that. That's how things get lost. I thought I told you. I can't work with so much noise. I need absolute silence, so please stop that. I swear I should just join Skynet!
I'm here.
Good. I marked the location of Mac's code reader and the battery pack on your map. Let me know when you find them.
Thank you.
Oh, shit!
Shouldn't be here. Skynet's right around the corner.
Yeah? Show me a corner Skynet's not around. You can leave now, because I'm not opening this door for anyone or anything.
I'm just here to help.
You want to help me? Fine. Go to my hideout at the metro station and bring back my transmitter. Then you'll help me.
All right, I can do that.
Closer to the parking lot. Look for a red van. The code reader should be inside.
How do you know I'm getting closer?
There are still plenty of resistance sensors in the area. I see everything. I'll be your eye in the sky.
Great.
house to the parking lot. Look for a red van. The code reader should be inside.
How do you know I'm getting closer?
There are still plenty of resistance sensors in the area. I see everything. I'll be your eye in the sky.
Great. Battery. Alvin, I'm halfway there.
Well, that's not quite true. Once you get the code reader working, you still have to find an HK to connect to. But don't worry, I'm sure they call them hunter killers just for intimidation.
Thank you. Thank you. Huh?